We keep it simple, but we don't really care. It's a 24/7 right kind of living and loving our slice of paradise heaven, and that's how we spend our time in an island state of mind. Toes buried in the white sand, far away from the worries on the mainland. We're all working on a 2-month tan, fishing and drinking and kissing and sinking like a sunset in that far off horizon. We got a beach bonfire popping, and if it dies down, we're going tiki bar hopping. Showing no signs of stopping. Down here it's coconuts and beer. We keep it simple, but we don't really care. It's a 24/7 right kind of living and loving our slice of paradise heaven, and that's how we spend our time in an island state of mind. In this tropical weather.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Smugglers Cove Resort Marina and Bar, right here live at in Isla Mirada, Florida, at the 85-mile marker. And by the way, it's Isla Mirada, not Isla Mirada. It's Isla Mirada, and Smugglers Cove is going to be jumping tonight because we've got a couple of things happening, and one is the amazing entertainer from right here in the Florida Keys, Scott Youngberg, is with us tonight. And also here on the dais, we call it at the head table, and we have moved up to the stage where we can do a little bit better filming of the event here. By the way, we're on Radio A1A and simulcasting on Beach Life Radio. Hello, everybody out there listening to us. And here at the dais is Daryl George, the general manager of Smugglers Cove Regina Resort Marina.
Whatever you want to call it, Don.
Emporium, my goodness. You know, I knew I would get tongue-tied. Hello, Daryl. Welcome to the microphone, bud.
Harry, welcome.
It's a good night.
Radio A1A. Chris Euland, Scott Youngberg, and everybody that's joining us tonight, welcome. This is going to be a very good evening.
It is indeed. The Key Largo Joe coffee is right over there, ready to be served. And you, I think we even have self-serve this evening. You can come by and have a taste of Key Largo Joe coffee. You can come by and have some of the great food. We've got sliders out here, Daryl. Tell me about these sliders. Are they? I mean, they. When I put my mouth in one, it tastes like steak.
Well, because it is steak.
What?
It is Angus sirloin, grade A Angus sirloin steak.
No kidding.
In between those slider buns.
And they've got the pickles on the side and the mustard and the mayonnaise and all of the, and some bonely hot sauce. And right there, we're going to dive into those things in just a little while, along with the bonely wings sitting to the side of
you. We have wonderful bonely buffalo wings.
And tonight, I think you're running a special, aren't you, to everyone that comes out that hears us on the radio that wants to try some of the amazing appetizers, right?
We do. These appetizers we're looking at,
okay,
they are appetizers on us. For the first hour.
The first hour, you can come by and get some appetizers. He's setting a table for you, folks. Come join us right here. Scott Youngberg is at the microphone as well. We can't leave you out, but I usually like to mention our host first.
He's the man, and you should.
If you're in someone's
home.
Welcome, Scott. Yeah, welcome to the microphone, Scott. How are you today?
I'm fantastic. Those sliders look great. I'm going to slide some of them down my throat before this night's over.
I heard that, and hopefully you'll be able to slide some of that good music out right here on the stage at Smugglers.
Hey,
right?
Life needs a soundtrack. That's my job.
Is it? Well, you know what? You live in the Florida Keys. What a soundtrack, right?
Yep.
And answering yep like that makes me ask you this question. What do you mean by that?
Hey, it's all of the, let's use a 25-cent word, the milieu of island life.
Ooh, on
every facet of it, whether it's just being fascinated looking at the frigate bird, yeah, watching that storm out over the sea,
yeah,
walking out your front door and knowing that the whole rest of the world is just right out there. That's what the Florida Keys is about.
Nice.
Absolutely. That's Scott Youngberg telling you about the Florida Keys. What he also does in his music as he tells you about the Florida Keys and his experiences through an amazing guitar. I mean, a great sounding guitar and a great voice. And known as a troubadour or a poet? What is your style of music?
I have heard all of those words. I've also heard alcohol-fueled jukebox. they all apply. I have actually done a troubadour gig. It's probably about 20 years ago. It was at the market downtown Chattanooga where I was hired to minstrel stroll the courtyard and go to table singing holiday music.
So that's a troubadour.
You always start somewhere.
But you've traveled the world playing keys, or your music, which has become keys music.
Just got back from finally taking a vacation, the first one in 8 years. It was my wife's and I, Susie, our 20th wedding anniversary. We went to Fraser, Colorado. I showed up at the Crooked Creek Saloon preparing to drink whiskey with a loaded guitar. We had a fun night. Made a lot of friends out there.
You're listening to Scott Youngberg here at Smugglers Cove Resort, Marina, and Restaurant and Bar. Did I get it all that time?
Come party with us under the bridge. Come join us.
You got to sometimes. And Daryl, what's special other than, hey, by the way, appetizers are on Daryl for the first hour. You better get here and get you some right now. What? Chef Theo, I think I saw Chef Theo stick his head around the corner there.
Chef Theo is here.
The tuna porque that we had a couple of weeks ago, someone had it again last week because of us having it before. Scott, have you ever had tuna porque? You know what we're talking about?
Is it tuna Y?
It is. No, it is like raw, ahi. Oh. Delicious.
It's known around here as tuna nachos at other establishments.
Yes.
Well, our customers love to tell us that they love our tuna poke.
Ooh, it's amazing. And that's not on the appetizer menu, folks. That's one of these preparations that Chef Theo puts his heart into. And it takes him a while to cut all that. I mean, it's amazing. Fresh.
It's hand-diced. Fresh ahi tuna.
A big, gigantic pile of it, man.
Yes, it is.
It's amazing. So, by the way, Smugglers is located at the 85-mile marker in Alamorada, and just above Alamorada is a place called Tavernier. And that's where Scott lives, right?
Oh, yeah. You do? For 18 years now.
18 years in Tavernier.
Just came down for a weekend 18 years ago.
I think I heard that one before.
I've heard that one before.
Have you ever played here at Smugglers?
Oh, sure have. Sure have. On and off during the years.
Have you?
Oh, yes.
This is a great place. Always
love it.
Indeed, it is. It's one of those kind of places that puts it all together. And, Daryl, if you had something that was called all-inclusive type of experience in the Keys, it would be Smugglers, would it not?
Smugglers is, and all-inclusive.
Arrive by boat, get a room, you don't have to leave.
That's right.
There you go.
The room part of it sometimes is enough to drive you nuts down here, just the room part. I think maybe if you called here and made a reservation and gave this place a try, you'd find that getting a room, first of all, is very simple to do. It's not necessarily season right now.
So that is correct.
Come get you a room here. It's very, very affordable. And you walk out here and you have entertainment almost every night. Is that right?
Every night. Every night we have entertainment. Every day we have wonderful flavors from our chefs. And every day you can go out on the water or you can sit by the water. Whatever you prefer, whatever your desire is, whatever your availability is.
Well, that the point you call it, I think. Is that what you call it out there, the point?
Quite often I call that the point. It's a couple different names depending on what day of the week, what event is happening out there.
That's an experience unto itself as the sun goes down and the boats start coming in for the evening. The bridge opens and closes and pisses off the locals. You know, this, especially sometimes, this place should be absolutely covered with people because of the bridge closing and them just pulling over and saying, the heck with it, right,
I've
Scott?
Done it.
This happens regularly.
Oh, man.
Hey, let's talk about what you said for a minute. Okay. Florida Keys season. We used to have an on-season and an off-season here.
That's right.
Now it's just a little bit less. The people are here. They're back. We're calling this off-season, and yet... Look at the highway.
The highway is packed. In this case, though, this is an undiscovered gem down here that has not. I don't know if they have actually had an opportunity to get it in front of just about, you know, the New York Times, for instance, or the Wall Street Journal run a full-page ad, if you put that in there, the place would be absolutely covered, because once you come stay here, once you have the food, right, Daryl?
Correct.
Once you have the experience, the tropical drinks, the tiki bar, what else can you ask for?
And you know, you say that, but when if we were in the New York Times, as an example,
okay, that's
and,
a good point.
And if this was packed all the time, which would be a good thing in its own merit, but it may lose some of the ambience
the local
that it
charm.
Has now. Because this is this is local charm. This is
a very loyal local following, too.
Quiet, comfortable, all-inclusive venue that once you get here, it's hard to leave. Once you get here, and this is the way Ala Morada was, and this is the way Ala Morada should be here at Smuggler's Cove.
No question about it. It's not polished. This is not one of those polished types of resorts that you come to. This has still got the smell and the feel. The woodwork is keys. This woodwork is amazing. I mean, what you've done with the remodeling of the rooms, for instance, they're brand spanking new. They are 5-star, 6-star, whatever it is, resort quality rooms.
I don't know if I'd go that far, but they are a room that you will love and you will not want to leave.
Well, you know something, you don't use your room a lot, do you, in the Keys?
Except right in the heat of the day when you need that air conditioning.
There you go. There you go. Well, one of the things I'd like to tell you about here, if I may, is the Family Fun Sunset Cruises also that are available right from your door at your room. They snorkel, sandbar. By the way, when it says sandbar, the sandbar in Ala Morada is something very special, and a trip to the sandbar sometimes may require that you take some adult beverages, and it may not, but I would suggest that you do. Everybody else is. Sightseeing tours, these echo tours that they do, and the sunsets here in Isla Morada in this part of the Florida Keys, I think they rival at least. I mean, don't you, Scott, the sunsets down in Key West?
Fantastic. They're magical. I've actually seen the green flash twice in the time that I've lived here.
No question. Come on. Daryl, have you seen the green flash?
I have.
There has to be no humidity, no clouds. It's got to be one of those nights where the sky is like a magnifying glass.
Is it got to be colder?
And
No.
It's just got to, there can't be any smog or haze. It's got to be clear, no clouds. And it's not just a flash. The sun goes down and then there's a green pop right afterwards.
Oh.
It's amazing.
Yeah. The first 7.5 years we lived here, we lived on the bay.
I see.
And so we watched every night from our balcony, from our couch.
Sure.
We watched the sunset.
It's almost like a sunset tradition. Whatever you're doing, you just quit.
Exactly.
You go outside.
And so when you see that many sunsets, you will see that green flash.
Yeah. Well, I had an opportunity when I lived in Long Key for a while to set up a camera, a good one, and I waited. And I waited, and I waited, and I never got one. And then I saw on Facebook the other day, Inga Hawkins from Frank Hawkins' wife from Key Largo. She's a professional photographer here, and she captured one with a photograph.
When did you live in Layton?
I lived in Layton about two years ago, right there, right by the little package store.
Okay, so we weren't neighbors, but when we first moved to the Keys, we lived in that first apartment on Snapper Creek Drive. We would walk out our front door and watch that sunset.
That's where I live.
Every night.
I live there. I live in the same apartment.
That we were in the canal apartment. That's funny.
And I was in the front.
Okay.
The front part.
That's funny.
That's
same
crazy,
house.
Scott. Hey, man.
Small world.
So you know about the sunsets right there in
yes.
Key Lime Bay? Oh, it's just...
Yep.
And
all the traffic that stops right when it's happening.
And it does. Now, there is an experience in that place in the Keys, and I hope that's okay for me to go there.
Sure.
Because Long Key is only a short drive from your room here at Smugglers.
It's the smallest town in Florida, officially.
It officially is. It's the one with the cop car. That when you see the cop car parked there that nobody's in, just slow down and then you're at Lime Tree Bay. So, but in this case, there's something very unusual right back there. There's something called Zangre Creek, named after Zangre, the author. That Zangre Creek, if you put a kayak in and you look over the side, it's like looking in a tropical fish tank. Mm-hmm. It is a tidal creek that goes in and out, and you time the tide just right, and it'll take you out. And then 2 hours later or so, it'll bring you right back to where you were. So you don't.
I know the Long Key Bite was one of his favorite places to fish.
Oh, listen, one of the most amazing clear water experiences. If you can get back there, I think it's all privately owned, though. I think the Zane Grey Creek. There may be there's a public park. Excuse me, there is. Go there, do the Zane Grey Creek. It's amazing. It's unbelievable. But right here at the sandbar, where Family Fun Sunset Cruises can take you, and out to the reef right there, these snorkeling tours are world class. This is the dive capital of the world. This is the fishing capital of the world. Then they have the Echo Tours as well. It's Captain Kathy and Captain Heidi's, and 305-896-2915. 305-896-2915, Family Fun Sunset Cruises, right from your door here at Smugglers. Have you ever been on one, Daryl?
I have to say I feel like I have been on one.
Yes.
Captain Kathy and Heidi, they have not taken me, or I have not asked them to.
Right.
But I will say every day when their customers are they're coming back in the marina, the harbor here, their customers have these smiles that go from
eye on life
from ear to ear to ear.
They really do.
And as Captain Kathy describes what they do, they provide a personalized educational tour.
Whoa.
Of the waters here in Isla Mirada.
And these gals know it too.
Well, you go to TripAdvisor and you look at their ratings at TripAdvisor.
Yeah.
They have well over 100 ratings and they're all 5 stars.
5 stars. All
yes.
This is from right here at your room and their boat. I don't know if they've come back in yet, but they do a couple of tours a day, do they not?
They do, yes.
Call them up, 305-896-2915. That's a Family Fun Sunset Cruises. And thanks to our sponsors, unbelievable. Key Largo Joe Coffee, we've set the service out here for free coffee, free appetizers for another 15 or 20 minutes. So get yourselves here, folks. No, excuse me, 45 more minutes, pardon me.
45, and so, they're going. Look, there's still some on there, but they're going.
Yep, free appetizers, come get them. By the way, in just a little while, we're going to take a short break right now, and in just a little while, Scott's going to come back first. We're going to do an interview about your music and what you're doing. We're going to have a feature entertainer, wonderful guy, a real Keys artist. For the last couple of 3 weeks, we've had artists from all over Florida and California, as a matter of fact. But here is something that I've been especially anxious to make happen, is for everyone to hear really, really good Keys music. Right, Daryl?
They'll be completely surprised and overjoyed.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They will love this.
And right here from these microphones, Scott Youngberg is going to treat us to some of his original work. And this work, of course, reflects his experiences here in the Florida Keys, where Radio A1A broadcast and simulcast on Beach Life Radio, where our sponsor, Bone Lee Gourmet Original Hot Sauce, is also served on these wonderful Bone Lee Gourmet Original Hot Sauce chicken wings. And you can put them on the slider too. And also, there's something special that's happening that's going to happen for Radio A1A, and also possibly someone that is a lucky person who attends an event here at Smugglers, and that is the Trop Rock Music Festival at Sea. They are a sponsor of Radio A1A. Radio A1A and our team will be on that ship, the Norwegian cruise line Escape. Deanna McElwee is the cruise director. She will take your call. Just look up Deanna McElwee on Facebook, Trop Rock Music Festival at Sea. Google it. Any browser, you put Trop Rock Music Festival at Sea. Up comes the registration page. Go ahead and get your room, because it's 7 days. Eight days, 7 nights of continuous Trop Rock music in the festival atmosphere, Trop Rock Music Festival. Radio A1A will be there with the cameras and the microphones, and we'll be broadcasting from the first ever Margaritaville at Sea. Yeah, Margaritaville at Sea, and we're going to be in the middle of it. And Chris Euland from Digital Publishing is going to be there. And it's always 5 o'clock somewhere where Chris is, that's for sure. Indeed. But we'd like to thank, that's his thumb coming out there. We'd like to thank Deanna especially for choosing Radio A1A and our sometimes talented team of, boom, see what I mean? But we've got technical difficulties, all right. So we're going to take a short break. Scooby's Popcorn. Don't forget, up in Tavernier. Also, anywhere you're online, scoobiespopcorn.com. Make sure you go there and get some of the most original Florida Keys popcorn as well. Have I got every one of the sponsors so far, Daryl?
I believe you have, but you did not emphasize it's the flavors of the popcorn.
Coconut
not
crunch.
Not the quality, but those flavors. Nowhere have I ever seen the flavors of popcorn that Scooby's has.
And a spicy one there, too.
Cheddar Gold, jalapeno, goodness. White cheddar, awesome. Caramel corn, of course. The Frying Hawaiian. Coconut crunch, and some chocolate thing. He says you better eat it right now. It's going to be melted.
And eat that, I've always eat been that a sucker with a for caramel corn.
Oh yeah, yes. This with the Kona Longboard would be amazing. Wow. Kona Longboard is our sponsor for beer tonight. I knew I missed one. Thank you, Daryl. All right,
let's
cheers, Scott. You're the man, and he is going to be back in just a little while and going to put on a wonderful show right here. We've got him sounding really good here on the radio. By the way, this is live. This is live, and you can hear it in just a few minutes where Scott Youngberg will treat us. Right, Scott?
Oh, you bet you. It's live radio. I'm sure to say something stupid.
No.
It happens.
Radio A1A, radioa1a.com. Music for the road to paradise. We'll be back in just a short.
Down here, it's coconuts and beer. We keep it simple, but we don't really care. It's a 24-7 right kind of living and loving our size of paradise. Heaven, yeah.
Welcome back, everybody, on Radio A1A. Hello, Chef Theo. The food is wonderful tonight. Thank you so much. We still have appetizers here ready for you to pick them up for free and have a bite. And also, Chef Theo is in the kitchen making some beautiful stuff here at Smugglers Cove Resort Marina Restaurant and Bar. And Chef Theo's just about to walk by the bar. We're going to see if he goes and grabs a drink from the ladies behind the bar there. No? Hey, Chef Theo, you're great, man. Anyway, thanks to everyone for listening in tonight. There's a number of people. Facebook is blowing up. Thanks to everyone out there for making sure that they spread the word that tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Youngberg is here with us live on Radio A1A, and we are simulcasting on Beach Life Radio right here in Isla Mirada, Florida, Florida Keys, and that is the guitar of Scott Youngberg. Hello, Scott. Hello again.
Hey, Harry. Good to be here.
It is so good to have you here. We're also videoing this for to make sure that we get it out and everybody can see that we actually do this live, and we actually do this with the facilities we have here in the Florida Keys.
That was a mistake. I was told I always had a face for radio.
No, he's a handsome man. Look at all that hair on his head. Huh? I wish I had all that, but I've got a little bit, but it'll work. Anyway, Radio A1A is proud to be here in the Keys, and we are a Florida Keys radio station, and we play trop rock music 24 hours, 7 days a week, and we would like to send a shout out to some of our programming, and then we're going to turn it over to Scott here in just a minute, I promise, but I've got to say hello to my good friend and brand new DJ, and he is a disc jockey, folks. From the word go, his name is Lyle Wilson. He's Weekdays with Wilson every morning, at every weekday morning at 8 o'clock and then all the way to 11. And he has the best interviews, except the ones I have with, like, Scott Youngberg. And he has telephone interviews at his tiki bar, Some Beach Studios, he calls it. And every morning...
Nice office.
He has a great office. I think his toes are in the pool. But Lyle Wilson is one of those kind of folks. You just like him, and everybody must like him because he's got the best numbers, radio numbers. And me, you know, having a little bit of the ownership of this station at heart, in my heart, when I see those numbers, I know he can see me grinning through the microphone because I'm like a cat eating briars. No, it's a possum eating briars. Isn't that what it is? Okay. Anyway, Scott's looking at me like, when are you going to stop talking, Harry? Well, I just want to pay homage to everyone out there and say thank you for listening, and a shout out to all you parrot heads and trop rockers and trop rock music fans everywhere that make a station like Radio A1A possible. Original music contributed by the artist to this station for the purpose of the betterment of the music contributed by the artist to this station. So it's one of those types of little ripples in a pond you were talking about,
oh,
Scott.
Oh, yeah. So all these mainstream radio stations play the music you already like. Hey, Radio A1A plays the music you're going to like.
You're going to like. And there are some people, man, that are just coming out that's unbelievable. Now, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, and all the ships at sea, I know you can hear me out there, and I want you to know that with us this afternoon at Smugglers Cove Resort, Marina, Restaurant, and Bar, the one, the only from Tavernier, Florida, in the Florida Keys, Scott Youngberg.
Thanks, Harry.
All right.
Well, we talked about the evolution of songs back before the commercial. It's funny, as a songwriter, you have to practice your own stuff because to forget the words to a song you wrote is, like, unforgivable.
Yeah.
So you gotta stay current even on your own stuff. It's just like everything else in your catalog.
Oh, man.
So Idle Speed is a very produced album. Many other Keys performers, like we said, you know, Steve Webb, Dave Fader, Lee Sharp, so many people played on it. The CD was 2 weeks away from being sent off to the factory, and I wrote another song. My producer was fantastic. We snuck it on the album as track number 6, just like it sounds right here, just the way I wrote it. No fill-ins or anything. This is called Adrift. Deep and far from shore, I can only ride the tide, remain adrift and abide. So hold me up or cut me free, to be swallowed by the sea. Adrift. I'll drift. I want for you to understand. I want to want to find dry land. I want to reach out my hand. But you just have to take it. If you want me to want to make it. Short of supplies on a raging sea, no volition, no crew, floating here to wait and see if I drown in the deep or if you. On keeping it all inside, when a word could set me free. Have mercy, God, make now I'm at the mercy of the sea. I could be your warm, dry breeze if only you would save me. I'm not seeking safety. Adrift. Adrift. I can't swim on my own anymore.
Oh, yeah. Scott Youngberg, Radio A1A's premier Florida Keys musician and artist. And that was written all by you, right?
Oh, yeah. Now, Susie and I do collaborate. She is quite the wordsmith.
Really?
About 50% of the originals she wrote the lyrics to, and I just did the arrangements.
Your wife?
Yes. And the other 50% are just brainchilds of my own.
You know, I heard someone they have dreams, and they get up and they write them down, or they turn their phone and record something. I think I heard something on the radio.
I have missed so many of those moments because I'm not that disciplined.
You just don't write it down, or you don't think about it?
When I'm sleeping, I don't wake up to write it
down.
Oh,
that. You just stay asleep. Well, I tell you what, you weren't asleep when you wrote that last one, man, I'll tell you. Radio A1A is proud to have at the microphone and with his guitar playing for us exclusively here at Smuggler's Cove, Scott Youngberg. Scott Youngberg lives in Tavernier, Florida, and take it away, Scott. Just enjoy yourself. And I gave you a little time to do your capo there, see?
Okay, well, we talked about imagery in music, but when I wrote this one, sure, it was all just about the wordplay. It's a little different. It's called The Difference. You might be early or always late. You might always worry or be quite sedate. You might be winning or losing at some game. But everyone is different, which makes us all the same. Some people set out to be masters of their fate. Others never go out, they sit at home and wait. But we all originate from the same template. Every individual has got similar DNA. One in one or two, two and one make three. One can make a difference that no one else can see. Standing still or still evolving, we all have our different problems. Stand together, we can solve them with the difference. It's what we have in common. He likes to drive, he sits at a desk. He wants to travel far, she never leaves the nest. You're the master of your craft, maybe the best. But either way you're different, just like all the rest. One and one or two, two and one make three. One can make a difference when no one else can see. Different faces, different names, aren't you glad we're not the same? Come the day, the whole world may see the difference another way.
Difference.
Woo! Something different for you there.
That's the one you talked about. That's the one. The one that was called Snowflake, right?
Yeah, it started out as an idea for a song called Snowflakes, but it just never happened that way.
Well, I'm so proud that you shared something other than, well, a snowflake would feel.
Well, come on. Yeah. That's not Trop Rock, and it's kind of lame.
No, it's, oh no, that's wonderful. That's the Harry Chapin part that came out in you.
Well, but then the final editing is what smooths it all out.
Oh, yeah. Fix it in the edit. But we're on live radio, so what you're hearing is live, Scott Youngberg. Live. Radio A1A.
This one is just how I wrote it, not how it ended up. One voice, one guitar. The CD's called Idle Speed. This is the title cut. It's called Idle Speed.
tide makes for a good ride. Stuck inside, waiting on the sun. I know when the wind blows, the rain won't go away. It isn't much fun. Today seems like a perfect day to launch my boat and sail away. No clouds above, the weather's past. The sea looks like a sheet of glass. Floating nowhere, feeling fine. No destination on my mind. Where I'm at is where I'll be. All I need is idle speed. It's 7 years bad luck, so I stay on hook. And if I need, I'll only move at idle speed. Floating nowhere, feeling fine. No destination on my mind. Where I'm at, where I'll be. All I need is idle speed.
Oh, how wonderful.
Idle speed.
That's the song by the title of the album, right?
That's the title track.
That's
yeah,
it. That's... and that can go to your website, right? ScottYoungberg.com?
Oh, yes. ScottYoungberg.com, B-E-R-G, like a young iceberg.
Yes.
Or Scott Youngberg Music on Facebook. Both have a music store.
Well, this is a complete, unbelievable treat to be here with Scott Youngberg, actually playing for us live right here on the radio and at Smugglers Cove Resort Marina Restaurant and Bar. And out comes more Kona Longboard. We're planning for a party tonight.
Cheers.
And they're going to ice it down. Hey, cheers is right. I guess on the air that you can tell that something special is happening here with Scott and his Taylor guitar. Is that a Taylor guitar?
That is a Taylor guitar.
You
it
can
is made
tell.
Out of cocobolo wood, which is actually heavier than water.
Really?
This guitar would sink. The only part that would try to float would be the cedar top.
The cedar top on it. So that's cedar. It's gorgeous.
The wood being as dense as it is, it doesn't take on water, and it doesn't swell with the humidity as much as other guitars.
So this is a good Florida Keys guitar.
Yeah.
Standby, right? Well,
yeah.
First of all, it sounds amazing. Taylor guitars are like a top of the line. Mercedes-Benz guitar.
Yeah, it was once upon a time I went into the humidor room at Morningstar Music and I played every Taylor they had and I said, guys, I love them, I'm sold, but I'm not buying today. What else you got? And they pulled this one out of the back and I went home with it that day.
Oh, neat.
When I take it for service, they call it that insane Taylor and they don't want to give it back to me.
Oh, that is that right? Well, it's insanely wonderful. You can probably tell. We're trying some new microphones tonight, too. I'm hoping...
They sound great.
I hope that the new audio that you're hearing tonight is going out there like I'm hearing it on the headphones. I hope it is, because that guitar sounds amazing, and you're treating us with some beautiful... You want to come up and say hello? Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Daryl, come on up. You've got to get in. By the way, I was just handed this... new album. He says it's not official.
Old
album, but not official. Not officially out there for sale. But guess what? The name of it is Live at Sunset. So Live at Sunset in the Keys, that's what we live for around here, is the sunsets, the sunsets that are like nothing else in the world. And I'm going to do something where this little album's concerned. I'll listen to it first. And if you've burped on it or something, and you know, like,
oh, then
too
use
much
that
to,
one.
Oh, use this one. Okay. No, I want to do a special because it is a Live at Sunset. I would like to, if you wouldn't mind, feature this one
of
night,
course. Go
so
right
that
ahead.
It's so that everyone can hear this at the same time that I hear it. Wouldn't that be great? That'd be fantastic, Daryl. People bringing your music here for Radio A1A all the time. You handed me some Tim D and his partner. They are now in the Radio A1A mix. It's the great music, and because they heard us here at Radio A1 at Smugglers. So Scott Youngberg. I keep wanting to call you Newberg. I don't know why that is. I guess I knew.
That's okay.
One.
I've been introduced at a festival as Scott Thornberry. It's all good as long as
Youngberg, like a young iceberg. But Youngberg, B-E-R-G. Yep. ScottYoungberg.com is where you can find his music. He's on iTunes. He's also, when you hear him on Radio A1A, I know a lot of you out there keep Radio A1A on. You'll see his album cover, Idle Speed, come up. Click on that right there, and it takes you straight to iTunes, so you can
quick
buy it.
Credit to Claudia Miller for that cover photograph. She's one of our local photographers.
She's amazing. Yeah. She is. Daryl is at the microphone, but I don't have your microphone. Wait a minute.
No, I'm not at the microphone.
You are not at the microphone. Where is it? Can you grab that microphone, or do I have it around my back? We're tangled up in microphones here. It doesn't have a. I don't know what happened to. No. We'll, this is it. Just plug that in there. That'll work. Hey, it's live radio.
It is live radio.
And Daryl is on the air.
Daryl, Smugglers Cove.
General manager of Smugglers Cove Resort, Marina, Restaurant, and Bar. See, it gets easier as the night goes on because I'm having a fresh, cold Kona longboard that Daryl, the general manager, delivered to me specially up here. Did I look like I was thirsty?
You, Harry, you looked like you were thirsty. You looked like you wanted a Kona longboard. And
I did.
I was very happy to bring it up to you.
Hey, listen, he's fed me sliders. He's done the Bone Lee hot wings. We've got some of the best French fries I've ever put in my mouth. Unbelievable fries here. But anyway, can you believe we have Scott Youngberg here at this table playing live for you? I mean, this is amazing.
Scott, welcome back to Smuggler's Cove. We're very pleased to have you back on stage with us and be honored by your presence.
Thank
Love
you.
The sounds.
Thank
keep
you.
It up, please.
Well, we will keep it up.
It's all up to you, buddy. Hey, listen. Facebook is going crazy. They like Scott Youngberg on Radio
A1A. Social media is blowing up.
Yes, it is. Thanks, guys, for listening. Well, I'll tell you, that Taylor guitar has been through it this afternoon because it was in the direct sunshine and the humidity.
Oh, yeah. Here's one of mine that I wrote a few years back, and now I hear it differently. This is called Now to Then. Of youth, I thought it was a dream. If this was as good as it got, that's okay. When things got rough, what we had was enough, and that's how it would stay. When things got good, I never understood it wouldn't always be that way. Time keeps moving on. Now is now the past. Every now becoming then, faster than the last. Every day I see this time in front of me. I howled at the moon but settled too soon. Now each passing year I'm disappearing. I want my hunger back for the time I still got. Don't get a do-over or another shot. Still don't know what I wanna be. How can this be? Complacency. At 43, I can't see the end of my immortality.
immortality. Time keeps moving on. Now is now the past. Every now becoming thin, faster than the last. Every day I see this time in front of me. Not what it was taught it should be. What it was told was in reality. The prices of the vices keep adding on to the cost of life, and then they're gone. If I have to believe the stories I'm told, I better grow up before I grow old. Time keeps moving on. Now is now the past. Every now becoming thin, faster than the last. Every day I see this time in front of me. This time in front of me. Don't really have the blues, with no retirement to lose. I'll keep wearing out my shoes until I can't walk.
Oh, yeah. Lord.
Yeah, when you're trying to finish a song, sometimes you fade it out, sometimes you resolve it, sometimes you just slam the door on it. That's what we chose for that.
I'll tell you this, you have some of the most interesting endings. They sometimes end with an unresolved chord.
Yes.
Are you?
I love that, actually.
You know,
because you're actually making a promise to the listener that you don't keep.
Yeah. How cool.
Well, time didn't keep its promise to you, so you're not keeping its promise.
Right, but I mean, you end with a...
You end a song like that and everybody goes...
No, there's supposed to be a...
But that is what makes music... I had an argument with someone the other day, and it was about an artist, and they said, well, he's just not very good. He's not very technically good, you know? And I said, now, wait just a second. Music is an interpretive art, just like modern art is an interpretive... Whatever. They're interpreting. Sometimes I don't get it. But in music, I get it, and I tell you why I get it. Because those individuals are writing something that is original and it's new and it has never been done before. Whether it is right or not, how are we to know sometimes? And whether that's the chord that should have been played there or not, how are we to know sometimes? But what Scott does, very interesting, is that sometimes music can become completely repetitive and an equation, a mathematical equation. Bach was bad about that. You knew how his song was going to end when it started, you know? But your songs, when you add those little nips and tucks and cuts and...
Well, you know, sometimes if you're writing a song in couplets, which means one line, then
another line.
One line, then another line.
Sure.
Well, on the third one line, one beat.
Yeah.
Don't do a line. Now you owe the listener something. Play your next line and then make it up at the end of the verse. That debt is still there, but you pay it back.
When you're writing, do you consciously think about this? And there's a new group of...
Not as a forethought.
Okay.
But I recognize it as an afterthought and work with it. I say, oh, I like what I just heard. I don't say, this is what I'm going to do and do it.
But so you don't outline it and say, I'm going to do a theme, repeat the theme, and...
No, I'll try a whole bunch of different stuff and... Whatever feels right.
Okay.
Is what I'll
go
with.
So did you end that song based on the message of that song? Effectively?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. I'll keep wearing out my shoes until I can't walk. There's not one more step to take after that. If you can't walk, you're done. Yeah.
Isn't that great? Radio A1A
Thank
listeners.
You for listening.
Oh, hey, listen. Hey, I hope some of the listeners are getting it, because I know some of them are avid Trop Rock fans, and they are... They're just discovering Scott Youngberg because they don't get to come to the Keys. They dream about the Keys. Do you know that? They spend their whole life especially during the winter, dreaming about being where we are,
well, that's
where
we live. Dreams in reality.
Well, let's do. Let's come to Smugglers Cove.
Does that.
Smugglers Cove really does. And on a night like this, when I'm handed an album that says Live at Sunset, and I'm going to be playing it, and we're at Sunset in Isla Mirada, the home of the best sunsets in the world, yeah, and listening to Scott. How lucky can we be? This is a magic moment, Daryl, at Smugglers.
Yes, this is a magic moment.
So sit back, everybody. Put your headphones on. This is the kind of music that we've got now that you can, when you put your headphones on, you can hear some of the sounds of the Florida Keys in the background, and you can hear an actual Florida Keys artist doing original Florida Keys music. His name is Scott Youngberg, and he's here live at Smugglers Cove Resort Marina.
Not all music is just about being clever and having hooks and all that. Sometimes you're just gonna tell a story, you know?
Tell me a story.
Okay.
Sage.
Ah, we're smudging. Nice.
That's sage.
Yes.
Oh. That's a nice smelling sage.
Yeah. We're burning some sage. It's a Florida Keys sage, by the way. It's from the soil of the Florida Keys.
That's a Harry's code for... No, I'm sorry.
No. It is sage. It's not pot. Okay, there's a little pot in it. Okay. No, there's really not.
You're going to get yourself in trouble here, Harry.
No.
No, don't they call that smudging? It gets all the evil spirits out. Yeah.
How did you know that?
Because I read.
Okay. Daryl doesn't believe there's evil spirits in the world.
Oh, that is not the case.
Oh, okay.
Not the case at all.
He does. Okay. Well, there's none here. Go ahead, Scott.
The story is pretty simple. Young man, summer vacation, southern debutante.
Ooh.
Fantastic 2 weeks.
Miss Alabama.
Good start to a story here.
Never sees her again. Reads in the paper 2 years later that she's getting married at a big socialite wedding.
Forrest Gump.
So he gets in his car, drives up the highway 2 hours, and shows up at the wedding quite uninvited. This is called Pink Champagne. Too fast. She's still drinking too much Stokely, busting balls and kicking ass. She's still dozing off at red lights and passing out behind the wheel, offering traffic cops mimosas, telling lies and making deals. Always over sleeping, staying out till midnight, spending all her family's money, raising hell and telling lies. Bet she met him at the Preakness, crashing parties at the club. She's still taking ballroom dancing when she finally fell in love. Don't let her know you saw me here. Don't even say I came. There's limousines lined up outside. Fountains of pink champagne. Fountains of pink champagne.
talk about Savannah. What's sweet soup about the sea? I'll bet she sold off all her horses. Doubt she ever thinks of me. Tonight, fountains of pink champagne, fountains of pink champagne, sweet champagne.
Pink champagne,
yeah.
Scott nice. Youngberg. Very
Thank
nice
you.
Song, man.
Thanks.
Not just pink champagne, fountains of pink champagne.
Fountains, yeah.
That's a lot of champagne.
Well, that's a big money wedding.
Indeed it is. Have you ever been to one?
And that guy doesn't care about that pink champagne, by the way.
He could care less. Everybody's getting thrown in the pool, that's for sure. Right? I don't know.
Well, I think I still have one promise to keep tonight. You specifically asked me for government cheese. So.
Now, hold on just a second. You don't have to rush into my favorite song that fast. I mean, you like to prolong the. Well, never mind. You're looking at me funny, Chris.
Because you're funny looking.
We want Susie to come up and talk too, sometime or other, about Humans of the Keys.
Come on, Susie.
Well, come on up.
We would love for you to. At some point in time, we really would like to talk about that because you guys do some of the great services for those individuals in the Keys that we would not normally recognize. Correct. Have you seen Humans of the Keys?
Humans of the Keys is a wonderful page. It helps so many people become acknowledged for what they need to be acknowledged for.
They won me over when they did the piece on Charlie Reisinger, the 97-year-old guy. And listen, he came here one day and did an interview with me, and he described this place in 1957 when he first came here. And
wow.
it was different, Scott.
Oh, a little bit.
A bit different. Well,
What color was the sunset back then? Was that before color?
Well, if you know Uncle Charlie, he may not have been around many. So I don't know. He's a pretty interesting, colorful character. You know, Uncle
Some
Charlie.
Stay the same. All right.
Oh, yeah. Well, Government Cheese is my favorite song because I told you the story about after the hurricanes on
yep.
the coast. They would bring us just truckloads of government cheese and. Back a long time ago, it was sea rations.
Don't even have to refrigerate it.
Oh no, you don't refrigerate it. It will last forever, just sitting out on a counter. But it did keep us alive in emergencies. It really did. And in the case of some musicians, sometimes that live in their car in Nashville and get frost on their beards. Oh, I don't know anybody like that, of course. But there are those musicians that would give their lives for a bit of government cheese, my friend. Am I right?
Yep.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Well, the world's been changing a little lately, and that's kind of what the song's about.
Cool.
Saying it yet, we're living asleep, which makes us slaves for them to keep. Our fathers gave us a republic and challenged us to keep it. I sometimes wonder if they'd be sick. They were here to see it, pursuing liberty and life. Build a home and find a wife. raise a family, proud and strong. Lately there's been something wrong. The changes are good, just not when we want it. I can't find the words, I'm just a little scared and haunted. If happiness is the root of it, I need some help with my pursuit of it. So get in line and help yourself, please, to the last of the government cheese. Most of my blood and all of my sweat ends up going to big government's percent. And anything I put away, loses value every day. The left hand working against the right. This didn't happen overnight. We let it go, we gave it up. So stay in line and stay shut up. The changes are good, just not the one we wanted. I'm just a little scared and haunted. If happiness is the root of it, I need some help with my pursuit of it. So get in line and help yourself, please, to the last of the government cheese. Everybody's waiting for a change, but not if they have to rearrange the life they've always known. But I think it can be shown. The middle keeps losing again and again. The poor have given up on waiting for when. The rich would be richer if they'd see the big picture and not have to win by so damn much.
Scott Youngberg, everybody. Wow. Government Cheese, my favorite song, of course, and we play it a lot on Radio A1A. Imagine that. But you need to play it a lot too and own your own copy of it. Support live music by coming to here at Smugglers, where Daryl is committed to live music. Daryl is one of the few that has live music almost six nights a week. Is that right?
There are seven nights every week, by the way.
You mean you have live music here seven nights a week? You
I see, was told there was no math involved.
Oh yeah, excuse me.
He made me think. Seven nights a week. But, we have maybe even eight nights a week.
Hey,
or days a week.
Well, sometimes you do have something on the point and here at the same time, so that'd be 8 days a week, wouldn't it, if you go to
it
both
could,
places?
Could be.
But I'll tell you this. It's places like yours, Daryl, that keep the music alive. Because here we are tonight making it possible for people all across the world to hear Scott Youngberg for the very first time. A lot of the Radio A1A normal listeners, the ones that listen all the time, they've heard him, they know who he is, and they've bought his music.
I went international a couple months ago.
Did you?
A guy in Denmark bought my CD.
No kidding.
Yeah, a guy in Denmark. He bought it off the write-up, so I am international now.
Off the write-up. What is the write-up? What is the?
Just whatever CD baby has, you know, about the.
So he bought a physical CD.
Yes, he bought
a physical CD.
Yeah, not download. Yeah.
Interesting.
From Denmark. Yeah.
So now your music is in Denmark. It's got to make you feel like a million bucks.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. I mean, from the Florida Keys, Tavernier is a little bitty place, Daryl.
It is a very little bitty place.
I mean,
it is a small town, and that's
but
why
like I
we
said earlier,
here.
You walk out your front door, and the whole world is right there.
That's right.
It's so interesting. I tell people all the time. I say we live in a small town that the whole world passes through.
Yep.
And to see the whole world out there.
It is a shame that they don't stop to experience what we're experiencing here. Chris is getting it on video. Some of you will be able to see this, and we'll share that with you too. Sometimes he's about a week or two getting it out there and rendered because his internet is slow, and rendering a video with slow internet may...
AT&T.
AT&T. But let me tell you where the internet is not slow. Smugglers Cove Resort Marina Restaurant and Bar. Fast internet. So you come in here, you're going to be able to listen to Radio A1A while you're having the wonderful food by Theo and the great tropical drinks by the staff here and all of the great stuff that they do, the echo tours, everything right here at Smugglers. Daryl, you put out some fabulous appetizers and they missed them. Can we do it next week? Would it be okay? Can we do appetizers again?
It will be okay. We can do appetizers. And I believe you'll probably have an announcement about some drawings and
indeed
some prizes.
We are going to be doing that. And next week also, if I may, Code Rum is bringing their entire troupe down here. Code Rum is going to make sure that we're...
Oh, don't miss that.
Oh, that cinnamon rum.
I think Smugglers has an affinity for rum.
Yeah, you think?
Through the years.
I think the Keys has an affinity for rum.
The Keys indeed.
We spent 3 weeks in Colorado, and there was one place we could find a good rum.
No.
That was it. They did have Mount Gay Extra Old.
No, that would keep me from jonesing.
Other than that, they thought Bacardi Silver was rum.
No. By the way, the Beach Bum Pirate will be right here on this stage doing the same thing that Scott is doing here tonight. And the Beach Bum Pirate has his own original take on being a pirate. Can I say? I mean, Chris has seen the Beach Bum Pirate before. He is an unusual, very talented artist, an original artist. He's going to be here to entertain us next week, along with the folks from Code Rum, Johnny Ringo. Johnny Ringo will be here. The original Johnny Ringo.
He's very original.
Wasn't that the one that went around Dead Man's Curve and didn't make it? I don't know. One of those
guys.
That
was Jan and Dean.
Oh, Johnny Ace. Oh, Jan and Dean. Scott, I waste time talking with so much wonderful music sitting across the table from me.
Isn't that what radio's for?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, all of you out there on Radio A1A, Trop Rock 24/7. Waste time listening to that? You're not wasting time. I told someone the other day I'm going to take a few hours off this afternoon. He said, well, what are you going to do, Harry? I said, I'm going to lay back and listen to Trop Rock music.
There you go. Drink longboard beer.
Well, you know what? It's like it's not even a job. Of course it's not. Lyle Wilson every morning on Weekdays with Wilson, he refers to us up down here. He says, your shows, Harry. He's a DJ and I'm an interviewer. I guess I am. I hope I am. But his listening audience is so different. They're into the music and they talk about this. And this is a party happening with real musicians right here at Smugglers. And if you don't
get to eavesdrop.
And listen, if you drive up right now, where you can come hear something very special. It is extremely special. I do not understand, Daryl. For the life of me, I do not understand why we don't have 150, 200 people. We've only got a few folks here enjoying it, but we will. And I know you're committed to that very thing right there. And that's something that you keep bringing folks like Scott here and the Big Kahuna, Midnight Kahuna, and the things that you have brought here, the shows that you bring, the live music.
Some thunder and lightning.
That's real live thunder there from the Island Rock, Florida Keys.
Riders on the storm.
I tell you what. Hey, Scott, we're going to let you sing one more, and then we're going to take a look at this sky.
And then we'll be Men in a Hurry.
Thunder and the Keys, how wonderful.
Well, here's the closing cut from Idle Speed. It's called I'm Gone.
This time, spent here in your arms, gives meaning to this game. This time, home safe and warm, helps to keep me sane. But now the night is gone, it's time to be moving on. It's morning and I'm gone. When I'm here alone with you,
without shame. When I'm surrounded by your love, you call me by my name. But then the night is gone, it's time to be perfect on. It's morning and I'm gone. The road, I hear you crying. What can I say? I'm farther away every day. Home is where my thoughts are flying on wings of love. Can you feel how hard I'm trying? Is it hard enough? Someday I'll find a better way. Show you how I feel. You make my life real. Tonight I'll stand and play my songs, drink another beer. It's right, but sometimes I feel wrong. God, I wish that you were here. For now the night is gone, it's time to be perfect on. It's morning and I'm gone. I'm gone.
I'm gone.
Yeah.
All nice. Right. Thanks. Scott Youngberg, everybody.
Harry, thank you so much for having me sit in tonight. It's been a pure pleasure.
It really has. It's been one of those types of times. The time has flown talking to you, Scott. It's amazing because you opened up tonight to our audience out there in the world, and you shared your music from Idle Speed. And quite frankly, when you cruise the keys, how could you go fast?
When especially over the Channel 5 Bridge. That's when I always do the I Love Where I Live dance.
Oh, yes. Idle Speed.
Why is this guy driving so slowly?
No, I don't even bother. Not at Channel 5. On all the other bridges, yeah. All but right. On Channel 5, I just enjoy it, too.
I want to say one thing, though. I happen to know that you've spent some time recovering from some issues. Yes.
Most of last year in Boston, I kicked cancer's butt.
You did.
I am clear.
Congrats.
I had some cutting-edge medicine. And
congratulations, and
it was like,
bless
you, know,
you.
Losing a year of your life to have a rest of a life. It's a wonderful thing.
You stand out as a human being because, you know, it's not time for you to go anywhere. You've got music to write and people to influence and make us happy, make us cry. So, yes.
Scott Youngberg. Yes.
Yeah. Well, we're going to sign off for just a little while and check this weather. But let me tell you something. If you're out there, we're a pretty hardy bunch here in Isle of Marauder, aren't we, Daryl? We're not going to go anywhere. I think Scott needs to get his $10,000 Taylor guitar in a case.
Yeah,
$6,000, excuse me. But I'm looking at some pretty cool skies out there.
They are. Harry Tiefer, do we have a couple minutes?
Yes, go ahead.
A couple seconds anyways.
What would you like to say?
What I love, all the entertainers we have, what I love, Scott mentioned a little earlier about the permanence and the solidity of all the things around us, what we have, nature.
Right.
And he does one of the best jobs of bringing the permanence of what we have around us.
Wow.
And bring us closer to all the changes that we experience in our lives and bring us down here to the Keys where we experience or revisit the permanence of the ocean, the nature, the islands we live in. And I want to thank
you for bringing life gives you.
Bringing us closer to that.
Daryl. Oh, that's Isle of Marauder Thunder.
That was the permanence of nature.
There it is.
that is
never go away.
You know, that this just a fact of life in the Florida Keys. We have these types of things that blow across. We're in the middle of the ocean, Daryl. Sometimes we lose sight of that very thing. And when living in Tavernier, yeah, I don't know. Maybe you do. I don't know. I understand that somebody just stumbled on shore and they said, "Is there a Tavernier? Is that what it is?"
Yeah. Well, you know, there's those two streets, Zhejiangway and Zhejiangway.
Zhejiangway. Yeah.
Yeah. Zhejiang and Valjean. Well, that, apparently that was the pirate's daughters, or the two pirates, or whatever. And when he stumbled, this is all BS.
I love it.
Yeah, that was his first words. Is there a Tavernier?
Is there a Tavernier?
Yeah.
And Tavernier got his name, but of course the Tavernier Hotel is in a Buffett song. It's the Florida Keys.
Plus, Tavernier is on the hospital grid, so we get good power.
Indeed, we do. Indeed, you do. Isla Mirada, I don't know what happened to us down here, but every step along US 1, Radio A1A is named after this highway, by the way. This is State Road A1A and Federal Road US 1. Every step along this highway, you step off the highway and you discover something like Smugglers, which is a gem, and it's a gem until when it gets over-discovered, and sometimes things get over-discovered in the Keys, and you mentioned that earlier.
I did. And of course, we will always be a gem. We will always be discovered. Yeah. If we become over-discovered, we will, at least under my realm, we will make certain that this place remains what Isla Mirada was and what Isla Mirada should be, which is a very wonderful, quiet, quaint opportunity to experience the islands of the Florida Keys.
And to get here, it's called the Snake Creek Bridge. It's cursed by the locals, and it opens and closes at just the most inopportune times normally. And most of the tourists...
Especially when they're training a new bridge tender.
Maybe that's what it is. But if you're able to make it across the Snake Creek Bridge, just turn right. You can't just turn right and you're at Smuggler's Cove.
Or if you happen to be northbound and stopped at the bridge, you're set. Just pull in. Wait it out.
Pull in. Because we'll be waiting here for you. We really will.
Jump off the bridge while you're waiting and swim across the creek here.
You can do that if you want to. By the way, you can come by boat. Did I mention that? This is probably one of the best boat destinations in the Florida Keys. It's one of the most comfortable, well-protected. As a matter of fact, you can get food and liquor here very, very easily. And if you're tired of that damn boat... They've got rooms, good rooms.
And whether you have a small boat or a large yacht, we are one of the very few places that have both Atlantic access and intercoastal access, deep water access.
Deep water.
Where we can hold up to an 80-foot yacht in our harbor here.
And don't worry about your mast size, because the bridge opens all up, so that you can come right on in. You're going to piss off the locals, but you can come right on in.
Sassafras or Rickafras.
No. But do take the opportunity, folks. Especially, we're planning some really cool stuff during Meeting of the Minds, Scott. Meeting of the Minds is where the parrots' heads flock to the Florida Keys for that entire week as they work their way down to Key West for the official Parrot Head Convention. We want to make sure that everyone out there, if you listen to Trop Rock, then you know what a parrot head is, and we don't need to tell you what they do, the wonderful work as they party with a purpose. But what we'd like to do is appeal to you, try to make a little bit of a difference this time. The same places that are tourist worn out, Smugglers is not like that. This is not tourist worn out. This is one of those places you go, man, and so is Long Key. Man, I'm so glad I stopped here. Everybody says that about your food, Daryl.
We just, from Key West, we just had a food blogger, and I'll give her kudos, FloridaKeysGirl.com, and she's a food blogger, and on the way to the mainland, she stopped in, and she posted just a few days ago, last week, and she posted one of the best five fish tacos.
Oh, I saw that.
Did you see that? We were number three.
Three.
She says that this is her favorite place on the way to the mainland. This is her new favorite place on the way to the mainland.
Oh yeah, and there's some good places to choose from. But this is one of those places. Please try it. Next week, of course, the Code Rum throwdown. We're going to have some great rum. They have a cinnamon rum, they have a key lime rum, they have a spice rum, and they have a rum, I think. A rum?
See, I can't drink rum during my shows.
Why?
Rum makes me think I'm an interesting person and people want to hear what I have to say.
Oh, come on.
Oh, makes you think, not
yeah,
that.
It makes me. Oh. Yeah.
Well, then we have some Key Largo Joe coffee over there for you, Scott.
There
for
you.
But anyway, I'm going straight for the Key Largo Joe coffee tonight because I stumbled a couple of times, and Kona longboard's good, but about eight of them, probably not a good idea. Hey, what?
Have some Scooby's popcorn.
Okay, I'll do that.
Yeah, it'll soak it up.
I'm going to go have some sliders over there if there's any left of Chris. Oh, Chris is eating the last one.
I don't know. They look like they might be gone.
I'd like to say thanks to Chris Euland from Digital Publishing. Man, you do a good job. You really do a great Chris. Job of getting the videos out.
The Digidude.
Digidude himself, yes indeed. And I would like to thank Beach Life Radio for allowing us to simulcast, and Key Largo Joe and Larry Holmes and Lyle Wilson and Tammy
Kim. And we'd like
Kim.
To thank Harry Tieford for doing what he does.
Oh, bullshit.
Harry? Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, come on. No. But we are nominated for a Trop Rock Music Award if you want to, you know, cast a bomb. Hey, is that a shameful, yes, what the hell? Anyway.
It's not shameful to toot your own flute.
No, it's not. No, it's not. Thanks again to Scott Youngberg for being with us here live with all of you tonight on Radio A1A. Thanks to Daryl and Smugglers Cove Resort Marina Restaurant and Bar for having us here and for allowing us to produce something that is a little bit different. It is different.
A little bit. It's a lot of bit different.
This
is great.
That's what matters nowadays is something different.
And the only way that if you like what's going on here, Radio A1A listeners, I'm going to challenge you to do something for me. You come by and you see Daryl or you see somebody and you say, I heard you. And I want to make sure that they get the... I could care less about awards, really. What I would care about is you come by here and come see us. Because
challenge accepted.
Okay, come see us. Come meet us. We're here every Wednesday night, 6:30. We're here every Wednesday night. You can talk to Chris, and he'll talk your head off. He'll talk your ears off. You can talk to Daryl. He won't say but a couple of words, but they will be profane. Not profane.
Profane?
No.
I caught that.
That's what
I heard you.
Hey. And you hear individuals...
Pluck the people right out of the rooms.
Come on out, folks. But anyway, I challenge you, and Scott's taking the challenge. He's going to come hear us, and every Wednesday night at 6:30, we do appreciate. And we appreciate you listening to Radio A1A. Going to take a little short break, and if the cloud comes over, we're here till 10 o'clock, so we're going to be here for the duration. We're going to see if the cloud leaves us alone, if the weather is on our side, and we would love to get Susie up and talk about Humans of the Keys in just a little bit if she's still around. Radio A1A, radioa1a.com, music for the road to paradise. I'm hitting the button. We're going to take a break.
In this tropical weather, it all runs together.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Smugglers Cove Resort Marina Restaurant and Bar. We have decided to brave the weather. We've looked at the radar. And even though you hear thunder in the background, it seems to be heading the other way. Scott is over there chomping down on some of the sliders, the steak sliders. They're amazing.
They were good. I had one, too.
Did you? Oh, cool. Speaking of had one, too, Susie Youngberg is with me right now, and she happens to be the other half, and the better half, it appears, according to everything that I can see. Are you getting a good close-up of Susie?
Yes,
beautiful smile, Susie.
Thank you.
Scott. Scott has made the evil signal behind her head. But she puts up with... I mean, she is the other half of Scott Youngberg, and... I noticed while you were sitting out there listening to Scott, you had this beautiful smile on your face and a peaceful look. You love his music, don't you?
I do.
You really do?
I love it. Yep.
Well, do you hear him practicing when he's writing, or does he go to another room, or?
He practices at home.
He does.
Quite a bit, yeah.
Yeah. The reason that, I wanted to talk to you wasn't specifically that you were the other and better half of Scott Youngberg.
Well, talking about Scott, I do write a lot
of
the words for
That's
some
right.
of his songs.
That's right, he
so
said that.
Actually, the last song he did, I'm Gone, was my words.
All those are your words.
Some of it we collaborate on, but... I give him the basic. I give him a poem, and he makes it a song.
Oh, how wonderful! What a great partnership you guys have. See, everybody's up here taking pictures of you. Nobody took pictures of us today. So, you see, we need some. Chris, get more ladies on the show, please. Well, you're listening. Oh no, Scott. Scott just bared it all. Radio A1A broadcast all over the world, and Susie, don't get nervous, but we're going to tell them we want to tell them something that they don't already know about the keys, that there are human beings in the keys, that we're not just a bunch of automatons at tourist souvenir shops, or we're not your servers or whatever, that there are actually humans that live here. And you have an organization or are part of an organization called Humans of the Keys. Is that right?
I do. I actually have just recently become involved with them. I am now 50% owner of Humans of the Keys.
Oh, congratulations.
With a girl named Rhonda Hickson.
Yes.
Who has been doing it for a while now. And they do such an incredible job.
Yes, they do.
I just became enamored of it. And Rhonda actually lost her other partner.
Oh.
And she was going to let it go because it was just too much for her to do by herself.
Wow.
But she asked me if I would be interested in helping, and I just think it's too cool of a thing to let go. So I said, I will do anything I can to help.
Did you know her
going.
Previously? So did you?
I did not. No, we have
so
met
this
as
is
part
just,
of this.
Wow.
It's a brand new thing. They actually, I knew her ex-partner.
I see.
And she was familiar with my website and my blog, which is suzisworld.com, yeah. SUZISworld.com,
ooh.
Which is my own personal blog that I do. I do a lot of human interest things, a lot of Keys Island living. I keep a music calendar going all the time of live music in the Keys. So they were familiar with my writing, and then they asked me to come and be part of Humans.
So how do we link with this information, with the multimedia stuff that we're doing right now, to make sure that we get some of that on the radio station? What you're doing with Humans of the Keys and your music blog, and because there's nothing more than our folks want to know than where's the music.
Sure. And that's why I started the live music calendar on Susie's World, is because there's really not one place that you can go to find out who's playing where. So and I'm trying. It's a work in progress. I ask all the local musicians to help me, to send me their schedules.
It's tough, isn't it?
It's a little difficult.
So you cover how far in the Keys?
I try to do all of the Keys, but unfortunately, I really don't have any connections like in Marathon and Key West yet.
Yes.
So if you're a musician out there in Marathon or Key West, or Harry, you could probably help me.
I certainly would be
happy
to,
Susie. I would love to start including those on my calendar primarily. Yeah. It's just been the upper Keys to this point.
Chris, let's make sure that, see if we can get her linked into our system, so that we can make sure that we're posting some of her postings where you can hear music in the Keys. Chris handles all of our digital publishing and all of the websites and the getting everything linked together. And we're trying to put a calendar together ourselves.
Okay.
I was told today that you don't have a calendar. I can't tell what's on the station and when it's going to be on there. Well, it's there, but you know, it's that's what other people do. I'm an old musician myself, so those types of things. But it interests me about your calendar. That is so important to know when and where things are. Oh, I just missed that. Oh, you know, Buffett was in town? Oh, what? Come on. You know, or even better, you know, Scott Youngberg is now in town. Where is he?
I tend to focus on our local musicians more than,
sure,
than the big guys coming,
sure,
to town. But, you know, if I know Buffett's coming, I'll definitely put it on there.
Well, if Aerosmith comes to town, send him my way, okay? But no, really. Susie does a great service, but probably one of the ones that I've noticed most, especially, I have to admit, I copied one of Humans of the Keys. I copied one of your stories. I interviewed Uncle Charlie Reisinger, the 97-year-old Keys character, after seeing your post. When I saw the Humans of the Keys post, I put it on all of the sites that Uncle Charlie's not too social media conscious, but I put it on all the sites, and it got more bumps and hits. He's what? He did what? And your article explains, if you know Uncle Charlie, listen, I drove 1,000 miles to Alabama with Uncle Charlie in the same car in one day.
Wow.
12 hours with Uncle Charlie in a car.
But that was interesting.
Oh, let me tell you. it was wonderful. But your Humans of the Keys article did something more than just tell about Uncle Charlie. It opened up something that no one, not many people know about him. You know what I mean?
Right.
Not many people, even in the Keys, he lives in the very top part of Key Largo. And Humans of the Keys opens up information about those individuals in the Keys. Like, who else have you covered?
Again, I've just fairly recently become involved in it.
But I've seen it just about everybody.
Scott and I were actually featured a few last summer when he was going through his cancer treatment.
Oh,
and
man. So that's the type of thing.
The idea of Humans of the Keys, I think, is to let people know we're not just a tourist town. People do live here. It is a place that people right. call home. And we're trying to get people to tell their stories. What we hear all the time and what Rhonda has told me right. is she'll ask someone, you know, tell me your story. And a lot of the locals, especially what we call the old conks, will say, oh, my story's not interesting. I don't wow. have a story to tell. But then as soon as you ask them a few questions, you realize their story is fascinating, and you can get them to talk. So,
well, that's what is so wonderful about Humans of the Keys. And congratulations, Susie.
Oh, well, thank you. I'm very excited about it.
Oh,
it's
I can imagine.
My new project.
I can imagine. Thanks again. We're going to need to wrap it up because we're getting some of the wet stuff
the
coming in.
The rain is coming
it
in.
It is coming yep. in. So, Susie Youngberg and Scott Youngberg, thank you for being here. But, Susie, thank you for what you do for Humans of the
you,
Keys.
Thank you, Harry. Let me helping promote Humans
thank
of the
you,
Keys
Larry.
And Susie's World. I appreciate it.
Anytime. Radio A1A. Radio A1A music for the road to paradise. We'll be back again.
Our time in an island state of mind. Toes buried in the white sand, far away from the worries on the mainland. We're all working on a 2-month tan, fishing and drinking and kissing and sinking like a sunset in that far off horizon. We got a beach bonfire popping, and if it dies down, we're going tiki bar hopping. Showing no signs of stopping. Down here it's coconuts and beer. We keep it simple, but we don't really care. It's a 24/7 right kind of living, and loving our slice of paradise heaven. And that's how we spend our time in an island state of mind. In this tropical weather, it all runs together.
Together.
Down here, it's coconuts and beer. We keep it simple, but we don't.